Whoa, it's Delusion reporting from somewhere on spaceship Earth. Heading to work, 6 a.m. in the morning. First cold morning of the year, November 2nd. Brr. I don't know, man. Woke up, did my little morning prayer with baby Al, asked for guidance and strengthen my day today, because I realize it's become super important to my morning routine is to call in God and source energy and all the powers of the universe and the positive light to guide me through the day, because people are going crazy. And I've really noticed that, I don't know when, I mean, I've always known it, but I've really been noticing just how dark people are, like how trapped in the darkness most people are, man. Like a lot of people really close to my life were just caught in just this sort of defeated position about it, man. And I get it, like, you know, I'm not the most like 24/7, like, yeah, it's all like rainbows and unicorns, man, but I do have a faith that allows me to see the errors in my own ways. Like, I truthfully don't understand how people exist without God in their life, man. And I mean a God that's loving, not this weirdo stuff that's going on spaceship Earth right now, man. Like, there's some like madness going on out there, dude. And so I find that I have to really protect myself, because people are just in the darkness, like really in the darkness, and dwelling in there and on this just whole negative approach to it all. And I got it, man. I don't know. Maybe I don't get it anymore. I used to be full doom and gloomer, dude. Like, it's all doom and gloom, man. But you know what? Like, I don't know, man. It really has changed for me a lot. It's been a slow process. Like, that's where I'm super grateful that I'm an alcoholic drug addict, man, and that they crushed my previous life. And I had somewhere to go. I had some place to go and get with people that readjusted my perception, because, and they didn't push God, right? Like, I think that's the genius of where I went and found help, is like, yeah, it's in there, it's suggested, but like, you gotta go find your own spiritual beliefs and your own spiritual understanding of it all. And, you know, I've always been a pretty spiritual person, and I've always been searching for my God. And, you know, Once I found him, like, yeah, man, I Jesus Christ is my personal savior. You know, I don't talk about it a lot, because I really think that, like, you need to find your own center and the God thing. And me just sitting up here, like, banging your head about it, that's not productive at all, man. You know, because this is what I pray for in the morning. I pray that I can better serve my God, the Lord Jesus Christ, with my actions, that I can better fulfill what it is, because I've been given a second chance of life, right? Like, I look at my life, like 6 years ago, man, it was over to me, man, and here I am, man. I was just sitting there praying with little baby Owl, dude. Hologram made me lunch today. Minigram's getting up for school. Like, there's a miracle in there, right? There's only the grace of God in that story right there. And so I have to act accordingly, but I'm just another idiot with the cell phone at the end of the day, man. I don't read the signals right. I get mad and frustrated, and I'm kind of a jerk, and I can be an asshole and the whole thing, man. But you know, it's the constant recalibration. I mean, I guess it's my thing is, like, I just have decided not to, like, lay in my bed of crap, man. Like, yeah, I'll go jump in there every now and then, but like, I don't know, man. I've just been really noticing people like turning their back on God and deciding that there is no hope, and just attaching to the material world, man. Like I guess that's my one blessing, is like my little family unit, man, the four of us up on the mountain, like we are not attached to the stuff, dude. Like, yeah, I mean, everybody wants it to be a little bit easier, dude. Like, sweat and bills sucks, but at the end of the day, like, I am not worried about it, because I do have God in my life, man. And you know, but that's the weird thing, is like, you know, I listen to a lot of interesting radio shows, man. I listen to these one guys, Hagman and Hagman. Like, whatever, dude, go check them out on your own, dude. Hagman and Hagman. And you know, the real thing that they were, like, I was listening to this one preacher talk about, was like, you gotta realize that, like, you've made a lot of mistakes, call it sin, call it what you will, and you gotta get down and ask to be forgiven, because that forgiveness you ask for and will be granted is what you must return to the world, right? Like I no longer have the luxury to be angry and frustrated and doom and gloom, man. Like, I gotta do my very best to forgive those who would do me harm, because I've been forgiven, man. I've been given my second chance of life, and I've been given grace. And so I have to do that. And they were talking about how, like, anger and negativity is basically allowing the devil or darkness or whatever you want to call it into your life. It's like a passive invitation. Like, oh, I'm just gonna go be all like negative and angry and about it all. Like, so basically I've said, hey, come in, dark energy, and like run my life. When, like, you know what, man? That's what I was talking about. Like, drugs and alcohol brought me to my knees and made me ask for help from something beyond myself, dude. And that was God. And God came in and was like, look, dude, here's what you can do. And it was a slow process. Like, there was no like light switch that went on overnight. It's been a gradual process, and like, I get better and better each day. And you know, like, for every 20 steps I go forward, dude, I make two backwards ones, man. But those two backwards ones are pretty radical, man. They do have the ability to like kind of crush me in the moment. But the thing is like, I don't go back to the way I used to be, like, completely. Yeah, like, I gotta go touch my darkness just to realize I want to be in the light. Like, I know a bunch, like, it's just been weird, man. I know a lot of people who have turned their back on, like, the gift of sobriety, dude. Like, and I'm not one, you know, I don't preach that kind of stuff on my channel. Like, I just know for me, man, I was given the gift of sobriety, dude. And to each his own, man. But when you've been given the gift, because the only way you really get sober is because you have so destroyed your, like, existence in this 3D holographic reality called reality, that you turn to the multidimensional universe called God and ask for help. And God's like, all right, I'll help you, dude, because you asked me, and like, you're ready to receive my help. And then you get all better, dude. Life gets good, and you're like, oh, la-di-da, la-di-da. And then, boom, you forget that, like, it's a gift, and you decide to forget the gift, and you go back because life gets difficult, because you're not doing the same stuff you did in the beginning. Like, I look at it like, you know, like, Life got good, man. I kind of forgot a little bit, like a month ago. I started getting angry and frustrated and poor me and poor me. And all of a sudden, man, I was like, I got to go back to the stuff I did in the beginning, man. I gotta wake up in the morning and ask God for help. I have to pause for the cause. I have to look at the people that are frustrating me as teachers, dude. I have to approach everything as if I've been given the gift of forgiveness, right? And so, I've realized that I have to really protect myself from the negative people right now. And they're everywhere, man. Like really, but I can't hide in the cave. I can't hide up at my house because there's negative people. I have to go out with the armaments that have been given me and go do my work in the world, right? Which is to try to lead by example that you do not have to live in a negative headspace, man. There is a solution out there, man. There is one who will help you if you choose to ask for the help. Just saying, man. Just saying. It's out there for you. If you're in the negative headspace, just get on your knees and ask God for help, man. And God will help you, dude. And you can get even deeper into that question once you get there. Because all I've found is the pages of the book keep turning. And they keep opening themselves to me. And they keep filling me on information. Like, I look at my own life. You know, I've come full circle. Yeah. The wheel keeps on turning, man. The wheel keeps on turning. Again, I would advise you to go listen to Bob Marley's Uprising, start to finish, if you're in a negative headspace or you're afraid of what's going on Spaceship Earth, or the clouds are trying to kill you, or, you know, just there's a lot of dark energy out there, but like, none but ourselves can stop the time. You know what I'm saying? So let's change our own. I don't know, man. Do your own thing, dude. I'm just chiming in on my thoughts here on the way to work at 6 a.m. Sending love out there, peeps.